walk in shadow, move the silence, guard against extraterrestrial violence. But we ain't on no government list. We straight don't exist, no names and no fingerprints. Saw something strange, watch your back. But you never quite know where the MIBs is at.
Thank you. This afternoon, we have come together to witness the joining of these two lives, Daniel Miller and Emily McKinney. For them, out of the routine of ordinary life, the extraordinary has happened. They met each other, fell in love, and are finalizing it with their wedding today. Friends and families, we are gathered here this afternoon as we celebrate one of life's greatest moments and recognize the beauty of love that God has created as you join together in the vows of marriage. Marriage is a wonderful experience. I know. My wife and I have enjoyed 61 years of marriage. Emily and Daniel, to make a marriage work, will take love and forgiveness. It is often said that marriage is a 50-50 give and take, but it's really more than 100-100 give and take. You have each other's interests at heart, and you will always want the best for each other. It will take dedication to stay open to one another, to learn and grow together, even when this is not always easy to do. It will take faith to always be willing to go forward tomorrow, never really knowing what tomorrow will bring, and it will take commitment to hold true to the journey you both now pledge to share together. And now, I will hand you a mic, and you want to...
Okay. I think they're gonna know this about me because I'm crazy, but I forgot to write them on paper, so they're in my head. Yeah. I think a lot of people are probably surprised to see me here with you today, but nobody's more surprised than me because I knew if I was to ever be married again, I would have to meet someone that met a lot of criteria for me. And I didn't think that kind of person could ever exist until I met you. I knew that that man would have to be patient, and he would have to be, I mean, very, very patient to deal with me. Very kind, and he'd have to have a servant heart, and I would want him to be honest and caring, and he would have to love me and my children the same, and he'd have to accept that for all it is. And you're all those things. You're everything I could have ever wanted in a person to spend my life with. And I'm so thankful that we crossed paths. I vow to always be faithful to you, to honest and honest with you, even if that's a little mean sometimes. I stand by you. I vow to allow you to be my rock, and I vow to be your rock. And I make all the promises under God. I love you.
I didn't know God would put you in my life, but here you are. And I'm so glad He did. I believe He knew you would be a perfect woman. To be honest, I didn't know I would be in this position to marry someone again. When I got to know you more and more, I knew that I could marry this woman. I knew you were my person as we spent more and more time together. I would love and be honored to spend my rest of my life with you. Just looking at you makes me smile and realize what a lovely guy I am. You have a heart of gold, a lovely smile, and a beautiful lady. I love our big family. They are so fun to be around. I wouldn't change it in anything as long as we have a tradition. I love you.
Emily and Daniel, I would ask that you always treat each other with respect and remind yourselves often of what brought you together today. Give the highest priority to the tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your marriage deserves. When first frustration and difficulty assail your marriage, which they will, focus on what still seems right between you, not only the part that seems wrong. This way, when clouds of trouble hide the sun in your lives, and you lose sight of it for a moment, you can remember that the sun is still there. And if each of you will take responsibility for the quality of your life together, it will be marked by abundance and happiness. May I have the ring? Thank you. I'll let you keep that for a minute, okay? Oh, no, I'll take you both. Thank you. Let us pray. The wedding ring is the outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two loyal hearts in endless love. It is the seal of the vow that Emily and Daniel have made to each other. Bless, O God, these two who give each other the rings and who wear them as a sign of their love and commitment. May they ever abide in peace, living together in unity, love, and happiness for the rest of their lives. Emily, please place this ring on Daniel's finger and repeat after me. I take thee, Daniel Miller, to be my husband, to have and to hold, in sickness and in health, for richer or for poor, and I promise my love to you, and hold your hand every night, and never lose our spark for each other. With this ring, I do wed. Daniel, you will place this on Emily's finger. And repeat after me. I, Daniel Miller, take thee, McKinney, take thee, Emily McKinney, to be my wife, to have and to hold, and sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, and I promise my love to you, and hold your hand every night, and never lose our spark for each other. With this ring, I be wed. Emily and Daniel, insomuch as the two of you have agreed to live together in holy matrimony, you have promised to love each other. And by these vows, now having been heard, and make these pledges of your affection, I do, by virtue of being a minister of the gospel, and by the authority vested in me by the state of Tennessee, declare you to be husband and wife. What God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. You may kiss the bride. And now we have a sand ceremony. I think, yes, and I think we want the children to join us, right? Okay, if the children can join us in this sand ceremony. Hi. I may bless this. Together and today we especially celebrate the joining of man and wife. What a special time this is indeed. but we also celebrate the blending of a new family unit. Our prayer is for the entire family, that you would grant a spirit of peace and togetherness and cooperation and love. We pray for your special grace for this newly blended family. We pray that each family member would seek your direction and desire to do what is in the best interest of the family at large. And so we celebrate a day of new beginnings. We are so grateful that you are with us for this journey, and we pray that it will be a blessed journey. Please shower your grace upon this marriage and all within this new family. Beautiful. Gentlemen, if those who are here in the chapel will stand and go out and stand in the, on the deck, and then the bride and groom will exit, and we will introduce them, and then everyone can greet them. Okay, if you can exit the chapel. And all of you too. Then when they get out, you go to the door and I'll announce you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed my great honor to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Daniel Miller.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I could ask everyone to just take a side of the wall somewhere so we can keep our dance floor open, we're going to introduce our bridal party. So let me go ahead and get this door open first. Oh, never mind. All right, we're going to introduce our bridal party. So let's go ahead and bring our bridal party in. Let's bring them in. Come on, bridal party, come on in. Let's give a round of applause for our bridal party, y'all. All right, ladies and gentlemen, go ahead and stand up. Go ahead and stand up. Let's stand up, y'all. Let's get a proper introduction in here. Let's give a round of applause for who we came here to see tonight, Mr. and Mrs. Daniel and Emily Miller. I think y'all can get a little louder for Mr. and Mrs. Miller, y'all. All right, at this time, if I could have Bill come up. Bill, where are you at, Bill?
Okay, my let's bow our heads, folks. Father in heaven, we want to thank you for this day. We want to thank you for life and love that you provide all of us. We come here in celebration of the end of Daniel's new beginning. We ask that you bless them in their new life and give them patience and honesty, understanding, the ability to forgive and forget and always love. We want to thank you for the beautiful sun and the wonderful fall leaves. We want to thank you for the food we're about to receive. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, what we're going to do is we're going to start handing out. If you take a look at your tables, there's going to be a few tables that are reserved. Those tables will be going first, and then I'll be calling table numbers after that. So we're going to let our reserved tables, our bridal party, bride and groom eat first, of course, and then we'll be calling table numbers. So go ahead and enjoy the evening, and I'll be calling table numbers to dismiss you to eat.
She loves with her whole heart, and she loves big. Like I said, she loves to do everything big. I've also learned that she was late to everything. Right? It's okay. But as soon as she comes in, she's going to charm every single person in the room. So it totally makes it worth it. So over last year, I watched my best friend grow as a person, love a child that she didn't give birth to, have the light back in her eyes again. I'm sorry, a little emotional. And just watch her completely fall in love with this right now, right? Ooh. Daniel, thank you for putting that nothing off their thoughts. She deserves nothing but the best. And you love her just as big as she loves you. And I could not have picked a more perfect person than you. For her. And for all six of these children. You have loved them like your own, I feel like, from the start. You would never know that you were going to do something bad, right? Ladies, you can make your ovaries hurt watching. You're such a great person to everybody. Most of all, though, we survived an entire house renovation. And we didn't kill each other, and we didn't lose a limb. Actually, it's a little faster. Oh, I got you both grow in love. They ruined your families. And it's been an absolute pleasure to watch. I'm so happy for all of you. I'll tell you, the very first day I met you, I knew that you were her person. It was the way you looked at her when you thought she wasn't looking, and you thought nobody was looking. That kind of love is once in a lifetime. And Emily, I know that you appreciate that more than you think. And you deserve that, and I'm so happy for you. Sure. There's a saying, and I disagree with this, but it says, good guys always finish last. I say, you get two good guys together, and they will prevail. Daniel and Emily are the good guys in the story. Whew. So, here's the two good guys prevailing.
Mom, is that why?
Next up, we have Hannah.
For a couple of years now, and here's some of the things that I've learned. Miller knows all the lyrics to the Barbie Girl song. Yes. And he sings the male parts in the British accent, so if you want to hear that, just ask him. It is a true story. If you want to hear that story, I'll find it later. It's quite funny. You're wrong. Patrol when that happened when I found that out, so. he also pronounces quinoa, you know, like the food, guano for some reason. We played Cards Against Humanity, and I threw like a throwaway card, and there's quinoa, and he's read whatever the card said, said guano. I was like, why is guano? I said, let me see the card, I said, no, that's quinoa. And the other thing I learned is before Emily, the only thing in his fridge was chicken and mustard. That was it. I don't know how to say it ate, but that was all he had. So hopefully, I imagine their fridge is a little bit more full now with all the kids. And the last thing is, I've never seen Miller so happy ever than when he met Emily. When he first brought her up to me, I knew he found the one just by the way he lit up talking to her and talking about her. You could tell he's in love every time she was around. You know, it's rare to find two people that wait for each other, and I firmly believe that you two are those two. Sorry, I lost my spot there. You can tell by the way they are with each other, they are truly in love in every way. Someone once said, it doesn't matter if the guy's perfect or if the girl's perfect, as long as they're perfect for each other, and you two are perfect for each other. I wish you both a long and happy, loving marriage. I'm so glad to call you my best friend, Miller, and I'm even happier that you found a wonderful person to spend the rest of your life with. So if you raise your glass, which mine's over there, I'll grab it afterwards. Stanley Miller, your wedding day may come and go, but may you love girl forever. I love you both, and congratulations. Thank you.
All right, next up we have Lucas. Lucas.
It's all right to say I love you. It's all right to say I love you to someone every day. To obey our Lord's commandment in a real and vital way. The world is filled with sorrows that sometimes touch us all, and to know that we are loved lives us when we're filled. The heart can be loved place when no one comes to call, but when someone says I love you, we feel we're 10 feet tall. Loved the rainbow after the storm, roses on a sunnier day, a smile that lights a dark room and chases fear away. Those little words can mean so much, and they're not hard to say. It's all right to say I love you to someone every day.
That's beautiful. Next up, we have our couple's first dance. So if I have the bride and groom join the dance floor for their first dance.
I am nothing.
Let's give a round of applause for Mr. and Mrs. Miller. All right, our next dance for the evening will be our Daddy Daughter Dance.
Thank you. come out to meet you, tell you I'm sorry. You don't know how lovely you are. I had to find you, tell you I need you, tell you I set you apart. Tell me your secrets and ask me your questions. Oh, let's go back to the start. Running in circles, calling up tails, heads on the science apart. Nobody said it was easy. It's such a shame for us to part. Said it would be this hard. Oh, take me back to the start.
Now, when I thought you, I said we.
5 years or less.
Let's go party.
Cantina.